Many years ago, I had the dreaded P0420 code on my 2003 Accord, as well as a downstream oxygen sensor code for heater circuit malfunction. I didn't know much as I know now, and I took the chance of just throwing an oxygen sensor at the car. Although that gamble worked and resolved both codes, today I want to show how to test an oxygen sensor heater circuit so that you don't just throw parts at your vehicle. I also show other things that could cause a heater circuit code even when there's nothing wrong with the oxygen sensor. Now let's get this. Most recent cars feature a heated oxygen sensor or air fuel sensor, meaning that it has both the sensing circuit and the heater circuit. The function of the heater circuit is just to heat up the sensing element in the oxygen sensor so that it can begin to feed the PCM air fuel data as soon as possible. When the ECM detects that it's taking too long for the sensing side of the oxygen sensor to come up to temperature, it triggers one of the codes relating to a malfunction in the heater circuit. This test will work whether you have a downstream or upstream sensor. It doesn't really matter. If you have a heater circuit code, all you need is a multimeter. Set your multimeter to check for continuity. Alternatively, you can set it to resistance at about 200 ohms. I chose continuity because this multimeter gives you the resistance reading in addition to the audible beep, which is better for the video. So let's start with a known good sensor, the one on this 2017 Accord. I'll just detach the connector for this upstream air fuel sensor. Heated oxygen or air fuel sensors usually have at least three wires. As you can see here, the one I have has four wires. Other types may have more than four wires. The most important thing is to identify the two wires for the heater circuit. They would usually have the same color. In the case of these sensors for Honda, you can see that black is the color for the heater circuit. If you have a three-wire heated oxygen sensor and none of the two wires are the same color, you might just need to check online to find out what colors of the wire are for the heater circuit. You can see that these two black wires are the ones corresponding to these two prongs. I'll just connect the leads to it. Some of you may be wondering why I'm not using crocodile clips on the prongs. That's because the wire of the clips is going to add more resistance to the reading, and I'll demonstrate this in a bit. As you can hear, there's continuity, meaning that the heater element is not broken. Sometimes there may not be an open in the heater circuit, but the resistance reading may be out of spec. Resistance specifications varies across manufacturers widely, from as low as 0.9 ohms to as high as 15 ohms. For this Honda, the spec is 2.5 to 4 ohms, and as you can see, our reading here falls within that bracket. If there's continuity and the resistance is within spec, yet you still have an O2 sensor heater circuit code, don't forget that the heater circuit is made up of the heater element that is within the sensor, the wire of the sensor, as well as a fuse and a relay. People often forget these other components that are not within the sensor when troubleshooting a heater circuit code. On this 2017 Accord, the fuse for the oxygen heater circuit in the under dash fuse box is this number 7 15 amp FI sub fuse, while the relay is the PGM FI sub relay. If any of these are broken, you can have a heater circuit code for the O2 sensor. You just need to check the circuit diagram for your car to find out how your manufacturer has listed the fuse or relay for the heated circuit of this sensor. Also, don't forget to check for any corrosion in the connector pins, as this could also give you a code. Just to buttress my point earlier on measuring directly, I'm now using clips on the prongs, and as you can see, the resistance is now above 3 ohms compared to 2.5-ish ohms that it had before. Even though it's still within spec, if you're really querying the resistance of a suspect sensor, you want to measure this directly. Switching over to the second sensor, which gave me some nightmares years ago, and as you can see, there's no continuity at all, let alone talking of reading resistance. Once you get a result like this, you need to do a few more things to be doubly sure that the heater element is truly broken. Inspect the wires of the oxygen sensor, checking for fraying or for any breakage which could cause shorts, and also give you a heater circuit code. As you can see here, all the four wires, including the heater circuit ones, have some level of fraying, and it's possible that there may have been a short between these wires which may have caused the code in the first place. Just to double check, I'm going to pierce these wires directly above this fraying to see if we have any reading. And there you have it, still no continuity. If you have a result where the wire is the problem, you can clean up these wires, tape them up, try to do some repair on it, and if the code goes away, then you're good. However, inspecting this oxygen sensor more closely, there's a bit of a kink in this junction right here, and probably that's what snapped the wire within. Finally, this is just my approach of troubleshooting heater circuit oxygen codes. Honda actually goes the other way around, but I prefer to start at the sensor itself and work my way up. I guess one other best practice to observe here is that if you have any codes for the catalytic converter and any other emission related codes like the heater circuit or oxygen sensor codes, it's better to always deal with that code first, as the catalyst code may just be a parallel code from these other emission related codes. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace!